My name is Yelena Bronevetsky. I'm a postdoc at UCSF, and we're here in my lab, the McCune Lab at San Francisco General Hospital. So we have kind of multiple arms of the lab, and mine is more about human immunity and the development of the human immune system. So we study kind of how the neonatal immune system, so the immune system of babies, is different than the adults, and what that means for the baby's response to vaccination, whether the baby will develop allergies, and then along the lines of HIV, how the impact of maternal HIV infection influences the baby's immune system, and how whether the baby can respond to HIV treatment. I was born in Ukraine, and I came to America when I was 4. I'm from the East Coast. I grew up in New Jersey. My parents are both computer programmers. That's kind of the job of Russian immigrants. Being a child of immigrants, you know, education was always a big deal. There was not really a question of whether I would be going to college and all that stuff. That was kind of implicit. And in high school, I had great teachers and who encouraged me to do science, and I, you know, did well in school, and I went to college, and I was pretty sure I was going to do research, and I worked in labs. I also realized that science can take you around the world. So after college, I went and worked in a lab in Japan, and I met a lot of other people there who had used their scientific skills to work wherever they wanted. And that's one of the really fun parts of science, is getting to know people from all over the world, but then you share this same love of, in my case, biology. There aren't really typical days, which is, you know, the fun part of it. You know, this doesn't really feel like a grown-up kind of job, the kind you imagine when you're a kid, you know. On a typical day, I'll have one or two main experiments planned. So for me, that involves isolating some kind of sample. So that could be umbilical cord blood, or if I'm doing something with adult cells, then it would be adult blood, isolating the white blood cells from that, and then isolating T cells, or helper T cells, which are the cell type that I really study. And then doing all sorts of assays, looking at the expression of surface markers on those cells. So we use a flow cytometer. So that's a machine that basically you stain your cells with different antibodies, and the antibodies will recognize different markers on the surface of your cell. And the antibodies have fluorescent labels on them. And we use this machine. It's actually really cool. It shoots lasers at the cells, and based on how the laser hits the cell, then we get a readout, and then we know how much of that marker is on the cell. We're doing some really cool experiments now using genomic approaches. So basically we've found a set of genes that are differentially expressed in adults and in babies, and we're looking at those genes in umbilical cord blood, and we screen for these genes to have an idea of how mature the immune system of that baby is. The different composition of the immune system at birth could influence the downstream effects. And so we've got one study where we have umbilical cord blood samples from numerous sites all over the world where babies were born to HIV-infected mothers, and were given antiretroviral therapy within 48 hours of birth. And we're studying how the composition of the immune system in those babies influences whether they respond to that therapy, whether they can eventually get off the therapy and be basically cured of HIV.
What would you say to a young person today who wants to go into science and research, but they don't feel they can overcome their obstacles?
I mean, I think go for it. There's nothing special about the people who make it or don't make it, you know? We all just are excited and passionate, and that's what you need. You can be the smartest person in the world, but if you don't work hard and stay excited about what you do, then it doesn't matter. And, you know, especially for girls, I think it could probably be a little extra tough, because, you know, we can be a little harder on ourselves than we need to be. But as a woman in science, I feel like we can do just as much as anyone else and potentially more than the boys.